Do you know that I am the son of Khadija? Do you know that I am the son of Fatima? They all said, I have asked, and now we know all of this, and that's not going to stop us from shedding your blood on this day. But except that Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam continued to advise the army of Umar ibn Sa'd, when Umar ibn Sa'd looked toward his archer, and he said, oh, archer, surely this pertains to the son of his father. If we allow him to speak, he'll never stop talking. So bear witness in front of the Amir Yazid that I am the one to begin the battle. It is said that at this moment, Umar ibn Sa'd, he ordered 4,000 archers to begin to strike their arrows at the camp of Abbas and al-Husayn. Umar ibn Sa'd, he led out the first contingency of the battle. It is said that after 1 hour, 50 of the companions of Imam al-Husayn had already been killed. And after a couple of hours, Imam al-Husayn was left with no other companion. It is said that at this moment, Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam was approached by Ali ibn al-Akbar. Imam al-Husayn allowed him to fight. He killed 120. As he called out, Ana Ali ibn al-Husayn ibn Ali, Nahnu wa baytullah awla bin Nabi. أضربكم بالسيف يحمي عن أبي ضرب الغلام هاشمي العلوي and so one man he comes and he takes a spear and he strikes it into the chest of Ali ibn al-Akbar. Another man came and he took a dagger and he struck the head of Ali ibn al-Akbar. He called it to Baba alaykum in this salam. Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. He reaches the body of Ali ibn al-Akbar. He throws himself off the horse. He sees Ali ibn Akbar smiling, and then he sees Ali ibn Akbar crying. He says, oh my son Akbar, why do you smile and why do you cry? He says, I smile because I see my grandfather Rasulullah. He's coming to me with a cup of water from the pool of Kaifar. He says, Ali ibn Akbar, tell your father that I have one cup that's waiting for him in a couple of moments. At this moment, he says, I am your husband, and why do you cry? He says, because I see my grandmother, Fatima. She's beating herself on the head. And I'm not happy to be here. And he said, after a couple of moments, Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam is approached. By Fatima goes out until he falls out of the Shia Akbar. His body is trampled by the horses. Imam al-Husayn has to drag the body of Fatima back towards the tent. One by one, the Banu Hashim were killed off the plains of Karbala. Until Abid Fatima Akbar, he comes toward Imam al-Husayn. He says, oh, Abba Abdullah, let me go and fight. Imam al-Husayn says, oh, Akbar, if I let you go and fight, where is my army? I don't have an army anymore. At this moment, I'm going to open it up, but I'm going to do it up, and he was also saying, as of now, you don't have an army, let me go. But it's just that I've been coming up, but he attempts to bring water for the children. All of a sudden, a man strikes him on the right hand. Another man severs his left hand. Another man pierces an arrow through his right eye. A man comes and takes the dagger. He strikes it on the head of Abed Fadl al-Akbar. He falls out of Salaamu alayhi. Ya Aba Abdullah. After returning back with the body of Abed Fadl al-Akbar, it is said that Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, one of the Nabi's sisters, and Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, he goes back towards the tent of the Banu Hashim, and with all of the women, they came toward him. And they said, oh, Abba Abdullah, where is our Rasul Abbas? Where is our brother Abbas? And he said that Imam al-Husayn took the pillar of the tent, and he removed it. The entire tent fell. He said, that's what happened to Abbas. We don't have anything anymore. Imam al-Husayn nodded to Salah. Nobody there. Imam al-Husayn goes into the tent of his family. He sees nobody there. he goes into the temple of the Father, not far from his brothers, and he doesn't see anyone there. So he says, "Hey, not me." But he goes out onto the places, and he calls out, "Hey, this guy, is there anyone to help? Is there anyone to help me? Oh, Abba, I'm just now. If you pay for this message right now, you would see your Shia crying. You would see your Shia weeping. You would see your Shia grieving. Oh, Abba, I'm just now. We are here with you. Please take us." It is that at this moment when Abba, I'm just now, he makes that call, I'm just now, spirit of Solana. Three people will respond to word Abba Abdullah. The first one is saying, "Jesus, oh, for faith, whatever I can do for you, let me know." The second one of those who responded to the call of Abba Abdullah, you know who? This is the most golden friend. One of the narrations is that when Imam Hussein calls out these lines, the baby begins to move. And this is the only one of them. Imam Hussein alayhi salam, he goes towards Zainab and he utters that brilliant Yahweh, "Me, what are the Arabs? Give me my 6 months old infant. Give me that child that still breastfeeds on his mother." And it says that after a couple of moments, after taking the baby to the battlefield, Imam Hussein alayhi salam has an arrow pierced through the neck of his child. He walks back towards the tent. The king of Israel, Abba Abdullah, "Is my brother in any water? I am thirsty also." Imam Hussein had a the third one who responds towards the call of Imam Hussein. He is looking towards God, he is one of his sons. With all of his dedication to God, the friends of Yah Hussein. At this moment, Imam Hussein turns around. He sees Imam's into the army. He is throwing out of the tent, saying, "Oh, my aunt, Shaykh, give me a stick and a sword." Shaykh says, "Oh, I need you. What will you do with the stick? And what will you do with the sword?" And all the men said, "Oh, my God, Shaykh, with the stick I will stand, and with the sword I will defend my father, Abba." Imam Hussein, alayhi salam, he returns to the tent of Imam Hussein, alayhi salam. He puts him down, and at this moment, Imam Hussein, alayhi salam, said, "Oh, my father, Abba, Abdullah, where is my brother, Ali Rasta? Where is my uncle, Abba? Where is Tarsus? Where is Al? Where is Muhammad? Where is Ali Salada? Where is all of the companions?" Imam and Hussein said, "They're all gone." At this moment, Imam said, "They could have been here." He looked toward Abba, Abdullah, and he said, "Where is my brother and his friend?" At this moment, Imam and Hussein said, "He has also been martyred." At this moment, the disciple of our Savior David says, "Oh, Abba, Abdullah, let me go out and also be killed in no way." The Baba of the Savior said, "Oh, and all the Savior God, this is the day when you take over the Baba. This is the last way. He embraces it in the last moment. So take over the Savior." The Baba of the Savior 7 years later, he narrates the head that in that moment, "When my father, Abba, Abdullah, came and embraced me that final time, I hugged him and fled with that gut from his body." But the thing is that Imam Hussein hadn't even begun to fight on the day of Ashura, and the blood began to come out onto the throat of Imam Hussein. It is said that Imam Hussein, he tells Imam Hussein to remain faithful, that at this moment, Imam Hussein, alayhi salam, he goes into the tent of the women, he embraces his women, he embraces his children, he tells the orphans to remain faithful. Imam Hussein, alayhi salam, he wants to get on top of the horse, but he's not able to do so. No one is there to help him, so Zainab comes down, helps Abba Abdullah get on top of the horse. He's moving slowly towards the place of the Lord.
shut it in his call. Coming down from behind him, it was the voice of his mother, Fatima. Who was it? It was his sister, Zainab. Zainab called out, Belmash, Allah. He has the Sahara. Open up the hallway, please. He comes down from his office. He said, yes, my sister Zainab, what can I do for you? At this moment, Zainab said, oh, my brother, what can I do? Do you know any sister like me? But they said, oh, Zainab, do you know any brother like me? And he said that at this moment, Zainab, said, oh, my brother, Abba, remove your armor for one last moment. I remove your shirt one last moment. I want to see your neck, and I want to see your chest. At this moment, Abba Abdullah said, oh, Zainab, why do you need to see my neck? And why do you need to see my chest? You know what Zainab responded? We're going to see you, oh, Shua. My apologies, oh, Abba Abdullah. I don't know how I'm going to say this right now. Zainab says, after that man came and struck our mother Fatima, after that man came and he put the sword on the rib of my mother Fatima, on her last moment she told me, and she said on that day of Ashura, please go and kiss the neck of Abba Abdullah on my back, and kiss the neck of Abba Abdullah, because that's just the most dangerous thing we're going to be sitting on. And that neck of Abba Abdullah, which is going to be severed in a couple of them.
Of the Lord, your son, and of the Lord, the Lord, and of the Lord,
what's going on.
He runs to our
the rise of the Prophet. He takes the Prophet by the Allah. He shows the beard of Imam al-Hussein. He takes the dagger.